we're working with a technology called microfluidics, which is actually routing small amounts of fluid, hence the name of microfluidics, small amounts of fluid through these channels. The fluids then go through this small set of holes here, and the fluid, using fluid pressure, rises up out of the screen and deforms the surface to create physical buttons.
Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to raise the screen. And now, if you run your fingers over again, you now have physical buttons that come out of the surface. So you can...
Yeah, that looks pretty nice. Are the button positions fixed?
So in this generation, we can actually have multiple independent button sets. So you can have different groups, but just like a keyboard is fixed or buttons are fixed, yeah, these are fixed in position.
But you can have different sets.
You can have different sets, and actually we have a roadmap.
For different interfaces.
Yeah, sorry. We have a roadmap to get into fully reconfigurable as well.
So ultimately where we're going with this is that individually addressable pixels, we're calling them pixels, or touchable pixels, and at that point you'll have full software control, so the software can control buttons anywhere on the screen on demand. So that's what we're working towards on the next generation.
Will this add thickness to the devices?
So this is an example of a touch panel, touch display with our technology integrated into it. So we're just swapping out the cover lens with our panel, so same thickness. Touch is just adhered, laminated to the surface, and that's the display. So no additional thickness to the stack.
This is an example of the actual panel itself, which you can see is a thin, flexible, it's an elastic polymer. This is where the buttons actually rise up at.